ताड़ी पड़े तड़ 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 ताड़ी पड़े पांच नाड़ी एरना तोरण बंधाय पांच नाड़ी एरना तोरण बंधाय किया मा बैसी ने आव्यारे लोल किया मा बैसी ने आव्यारे लोल तड़ 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 ताड़ी पड़े तड़ 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 ताड़ी पड़े That used to be one of my favorite Gerba song when I was younger. Gerba is a traditional folk dance that began in the state of Gujarat in India. Gerba is normally played during the festival of Navratri. Navratri literally means nine nights. Navratri. This is a festival that celebrates the feminine energy, strength, shakti in all of us. During this time, goddess Durga, which is also known by other names like Kali Ma, Amme Ma, Mata Rani, is prayed upon and celebrated. Festival of Navratri is celebrated differently in different parts of India. For example, in the state of West Bengal, the tradition of Durga Puja is very prominent. In southern part of India, the ritual known as Golu is popular. In the state of Punjab, many people perform Jagran during Navratri. They also do Kanjak, which is celebrating nine little young girls and praying to them and imagining that they are the nine different avatars of Amba Ma or Durga Ma. In the state of Gujarat, the festival of Navratri is synonymous with Gerba. Gerba is normally performed in large circles where everybody's facing each other and the circle's moving in one direction, and in the center is a picture or photo of Ambe Ma or a murti, which is a statue of Ambe Ma. During Gerba, women of all ages put on their three-piece outfit famously known as Chaniya Choli or Ghagra Choli. Chaniya Choli, Chaniyo is the skirt, the bottom part, which is also known as Ghagra. Choli is the blouse, and the scarf is known as Odni or Chunni. Traditionally, the men would wear Kediya, which is a flary top, and pajamas or dhotis, which is the bottom part. Now, these days, boys like wearing kurtas or kafni pajama or whatever is more comfortable for them. During Gerba, in India, and wherever there are Gujarati people in this world, it normally begins at 7 or 8 in the evening and goes on till 2 or 3 in the morning in many places, and for 9 consecutive days. Now, people that are outside of India, we get to celebrate Navratri for almost a month because we could only do Garbas on the weekends. Don't worry, we're not dancing from 7 to 8 in the evening till 2 to 3 in the morning non-stop. It's normally broken down into three parts with little breaks in between. First part is Tron Tadi, which literally means three claps. And it goes like this. You begin with your left hand on the bottom, right hand on the top, turn it over, and the third clap is both hands go to your side. So it would be 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. You can try it. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. The song that I began this video with is a song that follows this three beats. So let's try this. I'm going to sing that song, and if we can all do the three claps together. Ready? Tad 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 tadi pade tad 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 tadi pade पांच नाड़ी एरना तोरण बंधाय पांच नाड़ी एरना तोरण बंधाय किया मा बैसी ने आव्यारे लोल किया मा बैसी ने आव्यारे लोल तड़ 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 ताड़ी पड़े तड़ 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 ताड़ी पड़े Nicely done! This is when the first break comes in after 2-3 hours of Tron Tadi na Garba. And this is like going to school where you have the short recess first and then the lunch hour. This is the short recess. During this time, everybody eats this yummy Gujarati food like papadi na lot. Do you like papadi na lot? Oh, my mouth's watery. Papadi na lot, then when you have dabeli, undiu, locho, kamar, samosa, and water, of course, to keep you replenished for the many hours of dancing still remaining. The second part is Be Tadi. Be in Gujarati is two. And now you know what tari is, clap. So this one is to clap, Garbo. And I'm gonna sing a few lines so if we can all do this together. But first I'll show you how you do this. You start to your left, it's the first clap. Then you turn and then you pick up the second clap from your right, turn again. So it's one, two, one, and two. So, pani kya tare, beniya me tadav nare, paade thi lapsyo pag, beda mara nandvanare. So, that's Betari na garba. Now, the next break is like your lunch break at school. It's a little bit longer. During this break, everybody gathers around in the center where the picture or the murti of Ambama is, and we all do aarti. This is where the actual praying for that strength and shakti happens. Then we all eat prasad, which is the offering that we gave all the yummy foods to the gods, and now we get to share it with the gods. The last part of the evening is known as dandiya ras, which is another unique folk dance to the state of Gujarat. And this one is played with sticks known as dandiya. So now that you know what we do in Navratri, what we wear, what we eat, let me tell you one of the versions of how the festival of Navratri came to be. Long time ago, there lived gods and demons in this world. The gods were known as Dev, and the demons were known as Danav. The demons were getting stronger and stronger day by day by using their trickery and lies and cheating. And the demon king known as Mahishasur was the strongest of them all. So the gods were worried because there was so much chaos in the world. So they ran to Brahma, Vishnu, Mahesh. Brahma is the creator of this world. Vishnu is the preserver. And Mahesh, who's also Lord Shiv, is the destroyer of this world, according to the Hindus. So all three of the big gods got together, gathered all of their powers and strength, all into one entity, the ultimate strength, and they called her Durga. Durga was beautiful. She was intelligent, she was gorgeous, and she was super duper strong. One day Durga was walking by and Mahishasur, the demon king, noticed her. He was mesmerized by her beauty. He fell in love. He wanted to marry her. But he was a demon king. He wasn't about to go ask her to marry him. So he sent his minions, other demons, to go ask her if she would marry the demon king. When the other demons came to Durga, she said, "Sure, I would marry your king. Except I have one condition. I took a vow that I'll only marry the one who battles me and wins the battle. So tell your king if he wants to marry me, he's going to have to fight me." Hearing this, Mahishasur was furious. How dare she refuse my proposal? But he was in love. So he said, "You know what? I'll fight her. How hard could it be to beat her?" So the battle began. The first day goes on, the second day goes on, third, four, five, six. Both sides are really, really strong. And as the battle's going on, Durga is just getting stronger and stronger. On the ninth day, Mahishasur realized that he needs to do something different. Mahishasur had the ability and magical power of transforming himself into any shape or form. So at the ninth day, when Durga is in her full form and she has a trident in her hand and she's stepping on Mahishasur and she's about to end him, Mahishasur turns himself into Shiv. Shiv is a god. So he thought if Durga sees that she's stepping on Shiv, she would stop and that would save his life. Well, Durga looks down and she sees, "Oh my God, I'm about to step on Shiv." Her tongue comes out as in shock. So sometimes you might see pictures of Kali Ma or Durga Ma where her tongue is sticking out. That's because she was in that shock in that moment. But right away Durga realized that, no, this is Mahishasur tricking me. So she steps down on him, she puts the trident through him and ends the demon king. The calmness comes back to the world, and Navratri is celebrated to enjoy this victory of good over evil. So now that you know how the story of Navratri came to be, put on your chaniya choli and your kedias and go out there and do some garba. And if you want to learn more about these festivals, come on over to sanskarteaching.com. I'm Vaishali Patel, and thank you for watching this video. Happy Navratri!